Children's TV Workshop presents Sesame Street, show 847, produced in color in New York at Reeves Teletape.
Caught that broom, the wind stopped. Wow. Oh, well. Never looked a look a gift broom in the mouth. Might as well sweep all this garbage up.
Ooh, curses! The wind blew that broom right out from under me and dumped me here. And I don't think I like it. But from the looks of it, I know I'm not in Oz anymore. I must be over the rainbow somewhere. Well, the sooner I can get out of here, the better I like it. Find my broom and fly away. My broom. My broom! What's he doing with my beautiful broom? Why? What do you think you're doing with my broom? Get it back!
Is this your broom?
Yes, it is my broom.
Lady, look, you gotta be more careful with this broom, you know. Wait a minute.
It's my broom.
Well, that may be true.
I don't have to be careful with anything.
You do, because that thing almost came right out. It came out of the sky and almost hit me right in the head.
Well, that was the wind. It was not me.
Well, you have to be more careful.
Well, I have nothing to do with be careful.
Calm down. You can't have the broom until you calm.
Let me have it.
You can't have the broom until you show me a little respect.
Oh, yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Oh, I forgot. I can't so much as lay a finger on that broom as long as somebody else is holding on to it. That's not fair. That's not fair. Well, I'll fix you. You may think you see the end of me, but you haven't. I'll be back.
Oh. Hey, lady. Whew. It's a very powerful broom. And a very mean lady. Well, she won't get this broom back until she shows me a little respect and dignity.
I? Ink.
Tina, come on. $6. Oh,
Nasty. Nasty cookie. So let's take Cinda, okay? Cinda! Who sits over? Who is he?
My name is Ramon Isaac Bastido.
We call him Chopo!
Let's play ball.
We all live in a capital I, in the middle of the desert, in the center of the sky, and all day long we polish on the eye to keep it clean and shiny so it brightens up the sky, rubbing it here and scrubbing it there, polishing the eye so high in the air. As we work, we sing a lively tune. It is great to be so happy on a busy afternoon. And when we're through with the day's only chore, we go into the eye and we close the door. Capital I, capital I, capital I, capital I.
Okay, watch this, Betty Lou.
Okay, Bert.
How about that?
Oh, you're very good, Bert.
I've been practicing.
You have?
Yeah.
Oh, that's wonderful. You're so relaxed, Bert.
Well, as relaxed as I can get.
That's really scary.
Yeah.
Oh, that was fun.
This is the hep part.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to touch my foot in a minute.
Oh.
See, huh?
Terrific.
I think I'll do it again.
Oh, you almost hit me that time.
Oh, watch me. I'll hit it again.
Oh, I'm losing my... Oh, huh. I'll race you.
I got you.
How
about that?
Oh, that was great.
Look at that. See my hands?
They're beautiful, Bert, like you.
Thank you. Now look at that.
Oh, you're so strong, Bert.
That's because you're so white.
Oh,
yeah. Ice cream. Ice cream. Strawberry ice cream. My favorite kind.
It's a long, hard climb, but I'm gonna get there. It's a long, hard climb, but I'm gonna get there. Yeah, I'm climbing to the morning sun. Well, the road is steep, but I'm gonna get there. Yeah, the road is steep, I'm gonna get there. Yeah, the road is steep, I'm gonna get there.
Of the letter I. I reminds me of words that begin with I, like ice cubes and ice fishing. Then there's ice skates, icicles, and of course, ice cream. I like ice cream in all kinds of weather. The letter I is easy to remember, especially on icy cold days.
How about some water, David? I'm buying.
Okay.
Where'd you get this broom?
Oh, you wouldn't believe it. You're not gonna believe this. I went outside, right? This wind came up out of nowhere, blowing like crazy. Then all of a sudden, I went outside and I looked up in the... There, all of a sudden, coming out of this cloud was this... I mean, this broom coming flying right at me about 100 miles an hour. So I ducked and I grabbed this broom. And all of a sudden, I grabbed the broom and the wind stopped. No kidding. I'm not kidding you, man. The wind stopped, right? Like that. And then all of a sudden, I turned around. What, you know who was there? A witch. A wicked witch was standing there. She was making all kinds of faces, yelling and screaming.
Witch. David, what is this? Some kind of a game?
What is this, David? Some kind of a game?
See, why don't you get out of here?
Not without my broom.
No, you can't have your broom until you show me a little respect.
Who says?
I say.
David, don't pay any attention to her. Just give us some water.
Okay. Well, so you want some water, my little pretty?
I'm not your little pretty.
Oh, I'll show you. So you're thirsty. So you want some water? This ought to quench your thirst.
See, I told you.
David.
Oh.
It's raining inside the store. It's not raining outside.
Look, I'm getting kind of wet. Can we go outside and get out of the rain?
Oh. Hello there. Do you know what this is?
It's a L with a ball on top.
Well, golly gee, I never thought of that, but it does look something like a one with a ball on top.
Not something like, exactly like. You got the mind of a flea.
Quiet down now. This is the letter I. Many words start with the letter I.
Many words start with the letter I.
And the one that springs to my lips is impolite. We don't want to be impolite. That means being rude or discourteous or having no manners.
Tell us all about it, bright boy.
Excuse me. Try not to be impolite. Thank you for your time.
Oh, waiter.
Yes, sir.
Hello there. I am Grover. I am your waiter, and I'm here to serve you. What can I get?
Yes, I'd like a bowl of hot alphabet soup.
A bowl of hot?
Make sure it's hot.
Make sure it's hot.
Right.
Okay, sir. Coming right up. Hey, Charlie, table 26 wants a hot alphabet soup.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
Do, 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 do. Do-do. Oh, how hot this is. You are going to love this. Oh, look at that delicious soup. There you are, sir.
Okay, I'll just check it out.
Check what out?
The alphabet.
Oh. Bon appetit.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Waiter!
Yes, sir.
There's a J missing in this soup. I don't want it without a J.
A J missing in the soup?
Yes.
Oh. Okay, I get you today, J. Charlie, I think there's a J missing in the soup. Yeah.
A, B,
okay,
C,
there.
EFG.
I get that J for the man. Okay. Okay, here's the J, sir. Sir,
right.
Here's your J.
Well, put it in the soup.
In the soup. Gotcha. Okay. There it goes. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, have fun.
Now, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N. Waiter!
Yes, sir.
Now the O is missing. Uh-huh. I don't want this soup without an O.
That's a bad day for you, isn't it, sir? Okay, I get you the O. I'll be right back. Oh, the O first, then J, and then the O. Charlie, I got a widow.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K,
L, M, N, O. Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, I have an O here for you.
Well, drop it in.
Yes, sir, drop it in. There's the O, okay?
Check it out.
Check it out. Sure, why not?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T-U-V-W-X-Y.
Don't tell me. Don't tell me.
No good.
I bet something is missing.
The Y is missing.
The Y is missing.
Nope, I'm wrong. I have a Y there.
I see the Y there.
Yeah, it's the Z.
See?
Yeah.
You can't always be right.
Well, okay, anyway, the Z, I get the Z. Missing.
All right, no, all right, don't rub it in.
Without a Z.
It's a good restaurant, don't rub it in. I get the Z.
All right.
First, the Y makes a mistake, and then he wants to see you.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Okay, sir. I think I'm going to make you very happy now. I have the Z right here, sir.
Well, it's about time.
There he goes. Kerplunk.
Okay, now let's see. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X,
Y,
and Z.
And Z, there. Now I bet you are all happy. Hmm?
Nope.
What?
The soup's cold. Take it back and get me another bowl.
Some of the words that begin with I, they get to be quite tricky, like intersection and illegal, irritate and icky. Many words that begin with I are longer than itchy and into. There's impossible and incredible and important too. The letter I is quite a pip. I think I'll take him on my trip. We'll have some fun and do a flip. Into my car away we'll zip. I'm glad to be with the letter I, 'cause he's so irresistible.
Thanks.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Hey, please stand still again. We like counting.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Stand still, please, please stand still. We like counting you. Just stand still a little while longer.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Nine.
Hey, we can't count you when you're all mixed up like that. So you think we can't count you? Watch this.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Thank you.
right. This will be take 11.
I. Iron. I.
Thank you very much.
Who you looking at, tiger? And what do you see? Hey, who you looking at, tiger? Are you looking at me while I'm looking at you? Who you looking at, tiger? And how do you feel? 'Cause when you look at me, tiger, could it be a meal that you're thinking about too? Because I wouldn't like that idea at all, not very much. Who you looking at, tiger? I hope you're not mad that I'm looking at you, tiger. 'Cause it sure would be bad to be bothering you, because you're such a magnificent animal, really, and I'm actually a nice person. And you wouldn't do anything funny, would you? Oh, boy.
I. 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 Ink. Woo!
Come on, come on.
Stop!
Far out!
That is some witch. She made it rain inside the store. I can't believe it. You know, I think you should just give her the broom. I mean,
no,
just
I'm
give
not.
It to
I
her
can't
get
do
rid
it.
Of
no,
her.
No, no, no. That lady came in yelling and screaming. I can't give her back this broom. I mean, she put me down and everything. I won't give her back this broom until she shows me a little respect.
Hey, guys. What's
Hi.
Happening?
What's happening? You won't believe. Oh. Big Bird, there is a wicked witch on Sesame Street. No kidding.
A witch?
A witch. You know.
You sure?
Yeah.
You have a very strong imagination.
No, she made it rain in the store. She's been zapping people all over the place. I mean, she's mad at everybody. Big
really?
Bird, listen, you better go back to your nest. If you don't want her to be mad at you, go back to your nest.
Well, no, I'm not going to. I'm a very brave bird, and I'm not afraid. I'm your friend, and I'm going to stay here and help you. If there's a witch bothering you, I'm going to help.
Okay,
let's see. If I'm going to help fight off a witch or something, I guess I'll need a stick.
A stick
or something. Hey, this will do good.
Wait, not the broom! No!
Oh, you got a customer, David.
No, that's the witch!
That's the witch! Oh, that's the witch! Oh, if you're the witch, then you better not bother my friend David, or else.
Well.
Yeah.
So, my fine feathered friend, you've got my broom now.
Well, and I'm not your fine feathered friend.
No, you're not. Well, give me back my broom.
Don't give it back to me. Don't give it up.
No,
broom.
No,
give
they say no.
No, give it back. I'll take it. Makes me furious. I forgot again. Now listen, you. If you don't give me back that broom, your store is going to be more than just wet when I finish with it. And furthermore, I'll turn you into a basketball. Bounce in a basket. And as for you, my fine feathered friend, how would you like to be turned into one of these?
Oh.
Wow. Gee whiz. Oh, look at that. A feather duster. Well, she wouldn't turn me into a feather duster, would she? Well, anyway, I'm not afraid, David. I'm going to stay here and help you protect Mr. Looper's store. Looper.
What if I had great big feet? Then I could clump around the house in my father's shoes, and they wouldn't fall off.
Oh.
Good night, Ernie. Good night.
Good night, Bert. Boy, am I thirsty. So thirsty.
Ernie, I'm trying to sleep, huh?
Well, I know, Bert. It's just that I'm very thirsty, that's all, Bert.
Well, if you're so thirsty, instead of just talking about it, Ernie, why don't you do something about it, huh?
Well, that's a good idea, Bert. Mm. Let's see. What'll I do? I know. I'll imagine that I'm drinking a nice tall glass of ice-cold water. Nope. Didn't work, Bert. Didn't work. I guess I'll just have to be thirsty.
Ernie, You don't have to be thirsty.
You're right.
Yeah.
Of course. I could ask you to get up and get me a glass of water, Bert. How about that?
Oh, well, sure, you could ask, but I won't do it, Ernie. You can get up and get yourself a glass of water.
Right.
Come on.
Why didn't I think of that? What a good idea. I'll just go get up and get myself a glass of water. Oh, boy, that was good. Had another one here. Oh, boy. Oh, that was great. Ah, well, it certainly is better now. I'm not thirsty anymore, Bert.
Good, Ernie.
Now I'm hungry. Boy, am I hungry. I know. What I'll do is I'll imagine I'm eating a big peanut butter and banana sandwich. How about that?
Once upon a time, there was an unhappy hand. It had four big, long fingers. One, two, three, four, and one short, stubby thumb. Now the thumb didn't like the fingers, and the fingers didn't like the thumb, so they kept far apart. One day, the hand found a new toy top. And since the thumb wouldn't play with the fingers, he tried to spin the top all by himself. But he couldn't get it spinning. And since the fingers wouldn't play with the thumb, they tried to spin the top without him. But they couldn't do it either. So the thumb decided to try again. But the fingers wanted to keep trying also. And before they realized it, they were all working together, thumb and fingers, and they spun the top. And they spun it again. And from then on, the hand was very happy. I guess it just goes to show you, a hand can't do what it has to do unless all the fingers cooperate.
Got a pen and nine. Nine.
three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Nine.
This is a cuckoo clock. It's called that because every hour a cuckoo bird comes out of this little door and tells you what time it is. Like now it's almost 3 o'clock, so very soon the little cuckoo bird will say cuckoo three times.
Excuse me, Mac.
Sorry.
Just step aside there.
Whoopsie daisy. Thanks, pal.
Hey, watch your toes there.
Come on, sorry.
Excuse me, Mac.
Cuckoo.
That's one.
Cuckoo.
Two.
Cuckoo.
Three.
Sorry. Come on, come on. Hey, look out. See you in an hour.
Three cuckoo birds.
Cerrado. Cerrado.
¿Eh? ¿Qué pasó?
Oh, look what me got.
What's that?
Oh, Ernie, special thing. Me bet with this machine, me can find out how many cookies in that cookie box.
Oh, how are you going to do that?
Well, this called cookie counter, my new invention.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Oh, yeah, let me show you. Me turn it on.
Huh?
There. Now, stand back.
Yeah?
Point rod to cookie box and listen. One, two, three, four. Five bells. That means five cookies in that box.
Oh, wow.
Go ahead.
Hey,
check.
Let me see.
Check. Good
okay,
boy.
Just a
good
second.
Counter. Good counter.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five.
Good hey, you're right.
Boy.
There are five cookies in here.
Yeah.
That's a wonderful thing. Can I look at that machine?
Sure, you hold the
oh,
counter.
What a great yeah. machine this is.
You've got to talk to it. Be nice to it.
What?
Okay.
Hmm? Well, gee, I could use a machine like this because sometimes I can't tell how many cookies I have in my cookie jar at home, you know? And I could use a machine like this to count the cookies in the cookie jar, because I can't see to the bottom of the cookie jar, you know? I could. Hey, listen, Cookie
yeah,
Monster,
yeah,
can I try it on the box of cookies now?
Well, I mean.
Let's see, okay, here we go. Pointing it at the box. Hey, CM?
What?
How come there are no bells?
Well, because there are no cookies.
Hmm?
Ernie?
Would you care to explain that?
Yeah, Ernie, take rod and point to my tummy.
To your tummy?
Yeah. Don't tickle, just point. Oh.
Two, three, four, five.
Yeah, cookies in tummy. Five cookies. Thank you, Ernie. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Abierto. Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado. Abierto. Cerrado.
Abierto. Cerrado.
Abierto. Cerrado.
Oh, dear. I've got to get my broom back. I can't leave without it. I've got to get it back. I've got to make a plan of some sort. Well, what can I do? Oh, dear. What can I do? Now, let me see. Oh, yes. This is what I have done. I've made it rain in the store, all wet and messy. That didn't work. And then I threatened David with turning him into a basketball. Bounce, bounce, bounce. Basket. That didn't work either. And then Then Big Bird. I told him I'd turn him into a feather duster. Feather duster, nothing at all. That didn't work either. Well, they all worked. They didn't work on them.
You know something? You have got to be the most beautiful person I have ever seen.
Oh, keep still.
Wow, I think I'm in love.
Really? Think. Ah, a plan. I have a plan. I'll disguise myself, and then nobody will know who I am. Now I'll say this little poem. Days and nights all filled with gloom. I'm not a witch. Till I get back my broom. Now I'll go into the store
and see if I can get my broom.
David, you don't have to worry when old Big Bird's on duty here. No siree. No wicked witch is gonna get past me. Yes, siree. I'm on guard. Oh. Hello. There's a nice lady coming in as a customer, David.
Okay.
Where is that witch? I'll fix her.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hi. You're new, aren't you, around here?
Yes. This is the first time I've been in the neighborhood, and I'm just looking around to get acquainted.
Wow, you sure came at a crazy time.
Oh, yes,
really?
You did.
There's a witch on Sesame Street.
Really?
Isn't that
a
something?
Witch?
Yes.
No kidding.
Why, you don't say.
Really? And she's zapping people, and she's threatening them?
Oh,
it's really something. It's amazing.
How dreadful.
She made it rain in the air? Really? I'm not kidding. Rain right here in the store. And it wasn't raining outside.
Oh, I can't believe it.
Would you like a cup of coffee or something?
Oh, no. Thank you. I don't drink coffee.
Oh, okay. You know what she wants? I mean, this whole thing. It's all this broom here. This old broom. I mean,
that old thing.
This whole thing.
What does she want that, though?
Well, we don't know.
Well, for goodness sake.
This whole thing. I mean, it's...
Well, I can't imagine anybody wanting that.
Yeah.
Can you?
No.
No. Could I... just hold that, just to feel what it feels like?
Sure, why not? Here.
Just put it down, and then I could pick it up. Huh? Would you mind?
No. Would you excuse me just a moment, just for a minute?
Well, you...
Just for a minute. I'll be right back.
Oh.
Maria.
What's the matter?
That's the witch. Witch.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know.
Why don't you just give her the broom and be rid of her?
No, man, she's been calling me names. She threatened me. She said she's gonna turn me into a basketball. I mean, I'm not gonna give her the broom until she starts treating me like a person. And then I'll give her the broom.
Shh.
I got it.
What?
I just came up with an idea. It's a way that make her treat me like a person and she'll get her broom back, so we both win. Come on. Mm-hmm. You know, that nasty old witch, she wanted to hold the broom too. You know that? Just let me hold it. But she was so terrible about it. I mean, she called me names, and she threatened me. She said she was going to turn me into a basketball. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine being nasty like that?
Oh, I can't imagine.
I didn't think a nice lady like you. I didn't think a nice lady like you would think that way. So, I mean, you could ask me real nice, couldn't you, if you wanted to hold the broom, right?
Yes, I could.
I'm sure you could.
Uh-huh.
How about it?
Do you mind, young man, would you please let me hold the broom?
certainly.
Just put it down, and then I can pick it up myself.
I got it! My broom!
Now that you got it, what are you gonna do?
No! I'm gonna fly back to Oz as fast as lightning and never see Sesame Street again! You did it!
It worked.
Oh, David!
Down. Up. Down.
Difference between up and down?
Up and down?
Yeah.
Oh, I think I know it. I know I make a up and down.
Up is up there, huh?
Up and down.
And down.
Up
and down.
Up
and down.
Up
and down. Hey, that's good. You know that real well.
Say up and down.
Yeah, up and down. Thank you, John John.
You're welcome.
Give me five. For later.
Other side.
Yeah.
Up. Down. Up. Down. Now, what did you learn about up and down?
Down is easier.
Up.
At some wheels and things. He looks and looks and thinks, but doesn't know what to do with them. So he goes to see his father. He tells his father all about the wheels and things. His father listens and thinks. His father moves the things about in his mind until he finds a way they will make something. He describes it to the kid, who runs back to the wheels and things and puts together the thing that his father told him about.
And now it's time for everybody's favorite reunion show, Here Is Your Life. And now, here is your life host,
Guy Smiley.
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you, everybody! Thank you! Hello, everybody, and welcome to the show. Tonight's guest has had a wonderful life and is someone you all know and love, a loaf of bread. Shh! Now, the loaf of bread should be here any minute. She thinks we ordered her because we wanted bread for a club sandwich, but we're really going to do her life. There she is now. Come in.
Hi. You ordered a loaf of bread?
Yes, indeedy, we did. Just sit it right on this chair.
Over here, yeah, okay. Hey, is this a TV studio?
Quiet.
I never been in a TV...
Oh. No, out, quick. Okay, here we go now. Pardon me, loaf of bread?
Yes. How many slices do you want?
I don't want any slices. All I want is to say to you, loaf of bread, here is your life! Yes! You, loaf of bread! Yes, it's true!
Why me?
Why you? Because you're so wonderful and delicious and nutritious. And now let's meet some of the people and things that went into making you that way. Listen to this voice.
I remember Loaf of Bread when she was nothing more than a recipe in a book.
Oh, no, that's not...
Yes, it is, all the way from the bakery down the street, Carol the Baker!
Oh, Carol, oh, you look sensational.
Hi, Ralphie.
Tell us, Carol, what was Loaf of Bread like way back then?
Well, see for yourself. She was an adorable little recipe.
Oh, yes, indeedy, she was. Now, Carol, stand back as we listen to these voices from Loaf of Bread's past.
Jolly Loaf of Bread, remember us?
I don't believe it. That's not.
Yes, it is. It's Cora Cow and Farmer Frankie.
This is wonderful.
Yes, indeedy. Now tell us, what did you all have to do with making Loaf of Bread what she is today?
Yes, well, I gave her some milk.
And Guy, I grew the wheat that gave her the flour.
And I mixed all that stuff up with some yeast, rolled it and baked it, and out came our loaf of bread.
Yeah!
Mighty marvelous.
That's right, I wouldn't be here if it weren't for them.
Isn't that wonderful, audience? Yes, and so you were baked. And then you sat on the baker's shelf. And you were happy with all those other loaves of bread.
Yes.
But then, someone came and bought a loaf of bread next to you. And that loaf of bread was your best friend.
Yes, that's sad but true.
You haven't seen that loaf for a long time. But we found her!
Oh, no!
Yes! She's now peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and French toast, and here they are all the way from Joe's Diner in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Betty and Melissa, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches!
Hi, Loaf! So glad to see you!
Oh, my darling!
And from the same loaf, Yvette and Danielle, French toast!
Oh, no!
Bread, here is your life. From a recipe on a page to something delicious to eat, we have been proud to bring you your life.
Thank you. Thank you ever so much.
Oh, it's so
and that's not all. We have a charm bracelet for you to remember this occasion. And there'll be a party for you and all your ingredients. All your relatives will be there too. Pumpernickel, seeded rolls, bagels, and French toast. But for now, it's goodbye from me, Guy Smiley, until next time.
Mira unas ruedas y otras cosas. Las mira y las mira y piensa, pero no sabe qué hacer con ellas. Así que va a ver a su papá. Le cuenta de las ruedas y las otras cosas. Su papá lo escucha y piensa. Mueve las cosas en su mente hasta que encuentra la forma de hacer algo con ellas. Después se lo describe al niño. el niño regresa corriendo a donde están las ruedas y otras cosas y construye lo que su papá le describió.
The road next to it. A bridge with a river going under it. A curly road.
A funny one too.
Yeah. Oh, now he's in his nest again.
Oh, not me. I'm glad she came here, because it was very interesting and really exciting.
Exciting? Maybe for you, but not for me. All I want to do is to get out of here and fly home to Oz where I belong. Room to Oz!
Bye, witch. Oh, she's flying. Well,
boy, I've never been so glad to get rid of somebody in my whole life.
Z. Zipper. Z.
Look at the penguins taking a bath.
A fuss, but them birds up there think I'm a motor bus. Oh, gee, there's a bird on me. Oh, don't you see? There's a bird on me. They sit there talking to each other, not to me. Now, how do I find a way to explain that I'm not a boat or a railway train? Little birdie, fly away. Don't you come back no other day. Shoo. Well, can't you see? There's a bird on me. Oh, woe is me. There's a bird on me. I'm so darn sick of every feathered friend. Oh, gee. Stop your chirping and quack, quack, quack. Come on, bird. Get off of my back.
We all live in a capital I in the middle of the desert.
in the center of the sky. And all day long we polish on the eye to keep it clean and shiny so it brightens up the sky. Rubbing it here and scrubbing it there, polishing the eye so high in the air. As we work, we sing a lively tune. It is great to be so happy on a busy afternoon. And when we're through with the day's only chore, we go into the eye and we close the door. Capital I, capital I, capital I, capital I.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Nine.
It's the broom!
I can't go through it again!
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters I and Z, and by the number 9. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Thank you.